to a chance. Yeah, boys, check that ass. Whoops, I'm a girl. Girl, girl, girl. Girl, you know you're my world.
Encore, I was on drugs.
Encore is not very good. It's an embarrassing disaster and the first black mark on M's so far near spotless career. Remember how I compared the first three albums to the original Star Wars trilogy? Well, if that's the case, then Encore is the Phantom Menace.
Now this is pod racing.
I mean, it's retarded, it's annoying, and it initially got well received based on name recognition alone. As I stated before, I was not looking forward to the review of this album, based solely on the fact that I didn't even want to finish the album. But I've stomached through it for you guys, so be happy. This is my Slim Shady Retrospective, and today I'll be reviewing Encore. Now, I'll be spending a little bit less time on each song than what I spent on my Eminem show review, not only because I don't really have a lot to say about these songs, but I also refuse to spend more effort talking about these songs than Marshall did making them.
My nigga, you just got roasted!
So let's start with the cover. I hate it. Not only is the framing totally uninteresting, but the color palette is vomit-inducing. Also, I know it's a small thing, but the title here really fucking irks me. The backwards E is a staple of Eminem, and it's always been used in the second E in a word. Except for here where they decide to use it on the first E instead of the second one. Also, look at that seamless photoshopping on the audience. So far, we're off to a great start. What sucks even more is that if you look at the original cover design, it's awesome. Unfortunately, though, it got replaced because of censorship issues. The back cover is actually alright, and the disc, well, the disc actually makes me mad, because the design for it is great. This album does not deserve this disc art. Anyway, let's go ahead and start this thing. So this album has an opening skit that's honestly not even worth mentioning. It's basically just a copy of the Eminem show's opening, except somehow made less interesting. So instead, let's just get right into the first song, Evil Deeds. This song is the perfect opening for the album due to the fact that I could sum up everything wrong with the entire album in this song. If I had to describe the song in one word, it'd be pathetic. This song is just embarrassing and starts off with a horribly sung hook that's totally off-key.
Father, please forgive me, for I know not what I do. I just never had the chance to ever meet you.
I can't sing.
And then jumps right into the first verse. And this verse spares no time in letting you know the caliber of quality that awaits you in this album.
Mama had a baby and its head popped off.
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 My mama don't want me, the next thing I know I'm getting dropped off.
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 What do I look like, some kind of idiot? Wait a minute, shit, don't answer that.
I guess I should also mention that at one point in the song, he says the word predominantly over and over again.
Predominantly, predominantly, everything's always predominantly, predominantly, white, predominantly black, but what about me, where does that leave me? Well, I guess that I'm between predominantly both of them. I think if I hear that fucking word again, I'ma scream.
I was originally gonna make a meme out of it, but like I said, I'm not putting more effort into this than Marshall. So instead, here's some sloppy seconds.
What's the fat ass nut?
If I had one good thing to say, it'd be that the beat is alright, and towards the end of the last verse, the song actually kind of picks up with this frantic energy that I think could really work for the song if it was slightly more polished. As is, though, what we were given, it's just pathetic. Oh my god, a good song! The next song is Never Enough, and I have to say, I'm surprised. Other than Toy Soldiers, I wasn't expecting to find a song that I actually liked. M's verse in the song is actually pretty damn good, and it feels close to the Eminem show's quality. Something tells me that this was one of the first songs they recorded for the album. And then Nate Dogg comes in with the hook, and he steals the show. Then again, he is my favorite vocalist, so it's no real surprise there.
No matter how many battles I've been eating, no matter how many magazines on my nuts, no matter how many MCs I eat up, oh, it's never enough. No matter how many battles I've been eating, no matter how many magazines on my nuts, no matter how many MCs I eat up, oh, oh, it's never enough.
And then 50 50 Cent comes in with the verse, and it's not that good. Then again, I'm not really a big fan of 50. I've never really been impressed with his actual rapping, and I kinda hate the way he sounds. Now, I know that his sound kinda came from his jaw getting shot, but that doesn't really justify his complete lack of energy. Everything I've heard from him leads me to believe that half a buck don't give a fuck. And not in the cool, nihilistic way, either. I'm talking about the too lazy to get out of bed and make something out of your life kinda way.
This looks like a job for Bipolar Bear! But I just can't seem to get out of bed this month.
I just don't feel any passion from him, and even though it's not really his fault, I'll just never really be a fan of slurred rapping. Still though, it's not like he ruins the song or anything, and given how I feel about 50 Cent as a whole, his verse here is definitely one of the better ones I've heard from him. And like I said, M brought his full performance and Nate Dogg stole the show, so overall, I'd say it's definitely a solid track. The next song is Yellow Brick Road, and I have very mixed feelings about it. I mean, on one hand, the beat initially is great. It has like this cool violin thing in the background, and it's kind of really fun and energetic. But after the first verse, the beat kind of loses its touch and becomes bland and kind of annoying. The first verse of the song is pretty good, and the hook is alright. But the problem is, the rapping as a whole is kind of underwhelming, and like I said, it kind of kills what it has going for it after the first verse of the song. Also, there just aren't really any individual lines that really stick out to me, good or bad, so it just kind of is an okay song. Overall, I'd say I like the song, but only really half of it, because after the first half of the song is done, I always tend to bail on it. The next song is Like Toy Soldiers, and it's easily the best song in the LP. It's one of the few songs that actually feels like it has a purpose. You see, this was around the same time that the Ja Rule 50 Cent beef and M's beef with Benzino were going on. Tensions were high and things were escalating. This song is basically a call for peace based on the fact that if things kept escalating, someone could have gotten killed. It sounds absurd that it would escalate to that level, but you have to realize that rap has its history. I mean, just look at Biggie and Pac. I mean, look at Surge Knight. This song exercised a restraint and maturity that we rarely ever saw from a pre-2010 Eminem. On top of all of that, his rapping here is the best on the CD, and the hook is a very powerful sample that fits the tone of the song perfectly. Overall, this song just works. The next song is Mosh, and it's not terrible per se, but it's not very good. I remember that in an interview that Eminem had promoting this album, this line was said.
Taking my stabs politically at freedom of speech, but you know, I've never been like that political of a rapper.
Excuse me, but what about Square Dance on the Eminem show? In fact, this song is basically just a less good copy of that. Also, the sound mixing is a little weird in this song. It constantly sounds like M's getting drowned out by the beat. Still though, the song isn't terrible, and other than a few audio mixing problems, there's nothing particularly annoying about it. And honestly, I'd say so far so good for this album. I mean, yeah, the first song sucked, but things are going pretty good after that. I mean, we've had one really, really good song, one pretty good song, one great song, and one kind of below average song. I mean, maybe this album isn't so bad.
Oh.
Puke is not very good. This song is just so goddamn whiny. Okay, so to put it in perspective, I listened to this song after a crushing breakup that left me depressed for months, and even I was like, dude, get over yourself. Every time he does that shit thing, I want to rip out my fucking ears. If I had to say one good thing about the song, I'd say that the beat is alright, and the line where he says that he needs to date someone who's named Kim, well, that's an okay line. It's not the worst song on the album, but it's definitely the most grating so far. Unfortunately though, we've only just begun the decline of the album, and things only get worse from here. The next song is my first single. This is not the instrumental for the song. This is actually the instrumental from the hip-hop classic Ain't No Fun by Snoop Dogg. It's a great song with the solid beat. It's made by Snoop Dogg. It features Corrupt, Nate Dogg, one of his early works, Nate Dogg. Let's see. It features Warren G. It's from his album Doggy Style. You should go check it out. This is not the instrumental for my first single. That is because the beat for my first single is the single worst beat I've ever heard, and I do not want to subject you to listening to it, nor do I feel like listening to it myself over and over again while editing this video, because quite frankly, this song is the only thing that I've ever listened to that gives me a headache and makes me nauseous every time I put it on. My first single is the worst song on the album. It is the worst song Eminem has ever made, and I may go as far as to say it's the worst song I've ever heard. I'd rather listen to pre-meme Nutshack. Fuck, I'd rather watch the Nutshack. There is nothing good about this song. This is no joke, no irony. I am actually pissed off. But Tim, I like this song. I don't give a goddamn shit what you think. Fuck this song. Next we have a Paul Rosenberg skit. And these are becoming so phoned in, it's ridiculous. These skits are starting to be done not because they actually fit or make any goddamn sense, but instead they're put in because, oh, we did it all those other times on those other albums. It's just a fucking gimmick at this point. Next! The next song is Rain Man, and I'm going to slit my fucking wrists! This song is the death of self-aware humor. I never thought that anything could kill it, but this fucking song! This song is literally only designed to annoy you and waste your time. Nothing interesting or entertaining is being said, it's just annoying. And he's so goddamn smug about it, saying,
I just did a whole song and I didn't say shit.
That's right, you didn't say shit. Now give me my fucking money back. This song is like that stupid little kid who keeps following you around and screaming in your ear about random bullshit. The only difference is that this song won't go away when I tell it it's adopted. The next song is... Big Weenie. Remember when I said at the beginning of this review that the song Evil Deeds was pathetic? Well, I'd like to retract that statement. I have never seen pathetic until this moment. My first single is still the worst song because it physically hurts me. But this song is by far the most incompetent thing I've ever heard. This is the worst diss track ever made. I try so hard to be subjective on my channel and all, but if you really think that this track is hot fire, you are objectively an idiot. Never reproduce. Let me lay out why this is the worst thing ever. Number 1, Toy Soldiers. In one of the only good songs on this album, Marshall establishes that he wants to make peace regarding the Ja Rule and Benzino beefs. 6 tracks later, here's a Benzino diss track. What? Number 2, the diss. Okay, so Eminem is responsible for some of the most vicious and awesome diss tracks in rap history. I mean, just listen to some of the venom he spits out in some of these songs.
What you gonna do when shit hits the fan? Are you gonna stand and fight like a man? And so it's sure as hard as you say you are. Or you gonna run and go get your body gone?
First off, fuck your songs and this shit you say. This my wife, but at least I got a bitch you gay.
Gonna ruin my career, you better get one.
Fake ass gangster. No more press. No more press. Rot, motherfuckers, rot.
Uh-huh.
Decay in the dirt, bitch. In the motherfucking dirt.
Now let's take a look at this song.
You're just jealous of me cause you just can't do what I do. So instead of just admitting it, you walk around and say all kinds of really mean things about me cause you're a meanie. A meanie.
Pippity caca poo poo. Psych, I'm kidding, I just wanted to see if you're still listening.
With tooth decay, your mouth is open, you're disgusting. What the fuck you eat for lunch? A bunch of sweets or something? What, you munch a bunch of crunch and munch? Your tooth is rotten, chew the gum, your breast stinks, wanna chew some gum?
Eminem murdered Benzino in the sauce and buried him in nail in the coffin. This song single-handedly managed to raise Benzino from the dead and bury M in his place. Fucking pathetic. Next is the M Calls Paul skit. It's just more useless, annoying bullshit. In this, he uses a voice modifier that is so goddamn grating, and this skit goes on for about a minute too long. I'd like to be able to say that there's nothing good about this track, But unfortunately, I have to give credit where credit's due. Towards the end of the skit, he does foreshadow the end of the album a little bit. And, you know, credit where credit's due, that's pretty good. The rest of it, though, is useless, annoying bullshit. And it's really pissing me off! Okay, so the next song is Just Lose It, and I'm kind of ashamed to admit it, but I actually kind of like it. Now, don't get me wrong, this song is trash, but I can't help it. This song is one of my guilty pleasures. It's fucking stupid, but I think I'm able to enjoy it solely based on the fact that for whatever reason, I just don't find it annoying. Even the stupid fucking Pee-wee Herman impression. Also, I think it's a decent party song. You know, something that you can awkwardly white person dance to. You know what it is? I think the thing that differentiates this stupid song from the other stupid songs on the album is that I think that this song is fun. Like, it's a song that I have a good time listening to, even though quality-wise, it's pretty bad, and to a lot of people, it's annoying. To me, it's just bouncy, fun, and energetic. Like I said, it's retarded, but apparently so am I. The next song is Ass Like That, and it's...
What do you mean my lawyers with Michael? He's too busy. I am tired. Britney Spears has sold us like a man, and I can say that then you'll laugh, because that is a puppet on my hand.
The way you shake it, I can't believe it. I ain't never seen a
ass like that.
Hey Tim, you in?
Okay, so the next song is Spend Some Time, and it's pretty bad, but given what we have been receiving, it's not nearly as bad. It's just another bitches ain't shit type of song done wrong. The sample in the hook is kind of alright, but the beat sucks, Eminem's verse sucks, 50's verse sucks, and Status Quo's verse is by far the worst. The only redeeming part of the song is that Obie Trice's verse, it's not great, but it at least feels like he's kind of trying, sort of. I mean, not a lot, but a lot more than the other three. It's not terrible, it's not good. I have nothing else to say about it. The next song is Mockingbird, and I really want to like this song, but unfortunately, I just can't. Before I state my problems with it, I should first at least tell you what I like about it. First off, the beat is beautiful. This is actually one of my favorite beats to listen to, and I listen to the instrumental for this song whenever I want to listen to something relaxing. Just the soft piano mixed in with the steady drum beat, it's just, I love it. I'm kind of a sucker for piano mixed with drums, and there's just such a rhythmatic, like, lullaby feel to it that it's just really relaxing. Also, this is one of the few songs on Encore that actually feels like it has a purpose. This song is very sweet and very sentimental, and it even has a few really good heartfelt lines like...
Haley, I know you miss your mom, and I know you miss your dad when I'm gone, but I'm trying to give you the life that I never had. Mommy wrapped the Christmas presents up and stuck them under the tree until some of them were from me, cause daddy couldn't buy them. I'll never forget that Christmas, I sat up the whole night crying.
So, what's the problem? Well, unfortunately, everything else. The execution on this song is just terrible. His rapping is just as stilted and lazy as the rest of the album. To quote the rap critic, the pure lackluster delivery murders the sentimentality of the music. And on top of that, remember how in the last review I said that Marshall can't sing?
I can't sing.
Well, Haley's song may have convinced you otherwise, but Mockingbird does confirm that notion.
What?
He sucks at singing and the song demonstrates it.
Now hush, little baby, don't you cry, everything's gonna be alright.
And it all sucks, because I want this song to be good. I can tell that Marshall cared when he was making this, so it hurts me to see it all fail so terribly. I know a lot of people really have a strong love for this song, and really attached to it, so let me clarify, I do not hate it. I liked part of it, I just wish that I could have liked more. The next song is Crazy in Love, and It's not very good. It's not very good. Like, the song starts out promisingly enough with a sample of Crazy on You by Heart, and it really builds up with this really exciting energy, but then M starts rapping and he just kills the song.
What?
Like, it's honestly jarring going from the hook back to the verses. His verses here are really, really obnoxious. They just stay at the same key the entire song. They don't get more energetic, they don't get less energetic, they just stay in limbo, and it's hard to listen to. I mean, I guess I'm okay with some of the ideas in this song, like how he approaches the relationship and all that, but it's just, it's a moot point because it's not a good song. I think any affection I would have for the song, all of it stems from an appreciation of the original song that it's sampling and not this song. So overall, Crazy in Love is another bust. Whipty fucking do. Okay, so the next song is One Shot, Two Shot, and surprisingly enough, I actually kind of like it. It feels kind of weird saying that. The song is strangely fun despite being about mass shootings. The song is frantic and everybody just feels so energized. It's not genius or anything, but like I said, I had a bit of fun listening to it. It's like a fight to survive when shit hits the fan. Bullets are flying and we get to see how everybody reacts. Of course, part of that just might be because the album has set the bar so low that I'll take anything better than bad. That being said, the hook here is catchy as fuck.
One shot, two shot, three shots, four shots, all I hear is gunshots. This is when a fun stops, bodies drop, hit the floor, music soft, party stops, everybody hit the door, somebody's licking shots off.
And the beat is pretty bouncy, so honestly, I'd put it on the same level as Just Lose It, to where it's not necessarily particularly good, but it's fun, bouncy, and I don't really find it, like, annoying, so I like it. Also, get yourself some liquor, and you too can take one or two shots with the One Shot, Two Shot drinking game. Take a shot every time someone in the comment section mentions Orlando.
Wake me up!
Wake me up and
I can't wake up!
Wake me up and
save me!
Okay, lastly, we get a skit called Final Thoughts, a song entitled Encore, and a final skit called Curtains Down, and the three tracks pretty much all come together as one big thing. Final Thoughts has M tearing up a piece of paper and then walking onto a cheering stage. Pretty cut and dry, but you know, whatever. And that's when the actual Encore song starts, and honestly, the song is okay. Nothing I'd listen to really intentionally, but it wasn't, like, hard to listen to at least. The hook is actually reasonably catchy, and M actually sounds like there was an ounce of effort put into it, and Dr. Dre is pretty good in it. 50 Cent is barely in it, but he kinda sucks when he is, so, you know, it's kind of a moot point. The song does go full retard at one point, though.
When Dr. Dre says crunk, you will get it crunk,
get it crunk, 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 crunk.
And when 50 Cent says jump, you get a 1 foot and
jump, jump, jump.
I could also talk about the whole detox thing, but honestly, I just don't care enough. And then there's the final skit, Curtains Down, where M infamously massacres the entire audience after his final song and then shoots himself. And honestly, I kinda like this idea. One of the few things I like about this album is its build up to this ending. That being said, I would have preferred a cool idea like this being done on a better album and maybe being more tied into the themes of the songs, but I guess I'll take whatever positive things I can get out of this piece of shit album. Okay, so before I tear into this album, I suppose I should at least tell you what tracks I actually thought were good. Like Toy Soldiers is definitely the best song on the album. Never Enough is pretty damn good, and Just Lose It and One Shot, Two Shot are guilty pleasures. Beyond that though, fuck this album. The worst songs on this album are definitely my first single, Rain Man, Big Weenie, and Ass Like That. Like, what the fuck happened? M was the best rapper of the early 2000s. He had three near-perfect albums, and then this? It left so many people confused. For example, Mr. Tracy Utter asks,
why is 90% if PPL down in any them and Encore question mark back when it first came out credits said it was beyond its time? I loved it at first listen.
Well, Tracy, allow me to explain it to you. Encore is trash. The humor is obnoxious, most of the beats are garbage, the bars are lazy and repetitive, and the songs are just passionless, pointless, or both. You know you fucked up when the selling point of your album is that 15% of it isn't horseshit. And it's not just bad, average music either. This music goes above and beyond the Call of Duty in how bad it gets.
Duty.
Like, I mean, one of the few songs that I actually like in this album has a line as stupid as this. Songs like Evil Deeds, Puke, and Big Weenie are just unbelievably pathetic, and songs like My First Single, Rain Man, and Ass Like That are the musical equivalent of child rape. After finishing this album, I'm shocked that I even had a problem with songs like Under the Influence and Amityville. In fact, Under the Influence has grown on me quite a bit since my Marshall Mathers LP review, and while I still hate Bizarre's verse in Amityville, M's final verse is actually pretty damn vicious, and I pretty much love it. But now the whole game has changed. Things have stooped down so low. Before, I was nitpicking to find the bad in everything, but with Encore, I have to nitpick to find the good. For 5 years, Eminem was at the top of his game, so what the fuck happened? Well, here's my opinion. Number one, drug use. Now, Marshall often blames this album on his drug addiction at the time.
Encore, I was on drugs!
And while I believe that that was a major part of it, I think that there's more to it. I mean, Marshall was doing drugs over the production of the last three albums, so what's up with the sudden shift in quality? Number two, relapse. No, not the album. You see, during the production of 8 Mile, Marshall made the decision to be sober while filming. The film was a nightmare in production, and after it was done, he started his drug binge off again, and this time it was harder than ever. I believe that in exercising his moderation during 8 Mile, he killed off his moderation for Encore. He overdid the drugs and stopped using his brain to write music. Number three, success. The Slim Shady LP was Marshall trying to prove himself. He was a white rapper entering the game, and he had to give it his all. For the Marshall Mathers LP, he needed to prove that he wasn't a one-trick pony, and he was responding to his new fame. The Eminem Show may have been his third album, but it was the first time he ever produced it by himself instead of Dre producing it. So Marshall was eager to prove that he could handle the project. He even kept the entire album to himself locked away, so if he fucked up on something, it would all be on him. And that makes three home runs. I mean, what did he have to prove for Encore? He already proved himself three times and the pressure was off. On top of all that, he proved himself as one of the best rappers alive, so he surrounded himself by yes men. I mean, who's going to critique Eminem, the greatest rapper ever? I mean, he knows more about rap than us. I mean, look at his past three albums. And so Encore had no challenge to beat and nothing to prove. And without that challenge, there was little to no passion. Once again, this reminds me of the Phantom Menace, a helmsman who's out of his mind and the yes men in suits who won't challenge him.
It's great.
It's gonna be great.
That's gonna be great.
It's gonna be great.
That's gonna be great.
That's what I think happened anyway. With any case, Encore is a mark on Eminem's career that almost entirely threw everything out the toilet. And after it was released, he didn't release another album for 5 years. And when he did make his return, well, we're not gonna go into that yet. Next on the retrospective, we're actually gonna switch things up a little bit and take a look at M's music outside of the already four albums we reviewed, from the beginning of his career all the way to 2004. Until then, for the good of hip-hop and Eminem's career, this album should probably be properly euthanized.
For thee, my lord, for thee, power hath descended forth from thy hand, our feet may swiftly carry out thy command. So we shall flow a river forth to thee, and taming with souls shall it ever be. Nomine Patri et Filii, Spiritus Sancti.
Everybody, just wanted to mention a few things before I leave you off. First off, I want to apologize for the audio in this video. Some stuff fucked up with my mics and I actually had to record it twice, and it ended up messing up both times. So that's why I sound so out of it during the recording, but I decided to keep that footage because I thought that me getting kind of tired and angry of re-recording kind of helped me sell my anger for Encore. So if you enjoyed it, great. If not, then, well, the audio is going to be fixed for the next couple videos, so just kind of hang in there. Also, I want to shout out a few videos that I had in mind when I made this video. The first one is a co-op review between the Rap Critic and Muse Reviews. They count down, like, the top 10 worst Eminem songs, and almost all of them are from Encore. And I watched that a long time ago, so I'm sure that a lot of the same opinions from that video seeped into this one. So go ahead and go check them out. The other video is a review from this reviewer called Show With No Name, and he reviews Encore, and once again, I saw it, and more than likely a few opinions of his slipped into my video, so I just want to shout him out, say go check him out, it was a good video. The last video I want to shout out is something pretty cool I found called The Real Encore, a fan edit of Eminem's Encore. It's by Blame Batman. It basically takes out all of the bullshit and puts in a couple of the bonus tracks and a few other tracks he made at the time and kind of just puts together into a decent album. Like, it still has its problems, it still has some shitty songs on it, but it's generally a whole lot better. So I definitely recommend checking it out if it's still up at the time of watching this. I've linked all three of the videos in the description, be sure to check them out. Lastly, the end of the year is coming up, and hopefully I'll have a decent amount of videos out before the end of the year, but you know how it is, schedules get kind of fucked at some point, so I'm working as hard as I can on this, and I hope I can pump out some stuff that you guys will enjoy. If you're new to the channel, be sure to give it a subscribe, be sure to like the video, share it around if you think it's worthy of it, and make sure that you have a great night. This is Tim the Fanboy Philosopher, signing out.